I'm Dr. Ian O'Neill. I work for Discovery News. I'm their space producer. My background is actually as a scientist. I'm a solar physicist. I've got my PhD in coronal physics. I think it is possible for humans to become an interstellar race. I think it certainly is possible. Not within my lifetime, probably not within the next 100 years, because we need some transformative technologies in between. Key one, I mean, at the moment we're testing on the International Space Station, we're testing life support systems, doing phenomenally well, but it's the International Space Station's close to Earth, so if something breaks down, you can conceivably just hop down and bring something back up. Obviously it's a little bit more complicated than that, but if you start putting human colonies on other planets, yeah, that's hard, but at least they've got a gravitational well where they've got a base there, and you assume they've got some sort of infrastructure working. But you put everybody onto a spaceship and send them out into interstellar space. There is no infrastructure there, there's no connection to Earth, especially once, you know, several years go by where the travel time of messages starts getting very, very, very long, because of course we're talking about light years. It could conceivably take, you know, several years for one message to get from A to B. So you've got the relativistic issues there as well. And certainly not without some massive breakthroughs in propulsion technology, I don't think that humans are going to become, you know, the Star Trek race we want to be, unless we develop the warp drive, and that'd be fantastic. We'd be able to travel around a galaxy at any speed we like. We can even go travel faster than the speed of light with the warp drive. So ideally, it'd be great to create the warp drive, but within our current understanding of technology and where it's going, with the iterative steps that we hope to make it between now and sending a probe to another star, I just don't see us becoming that spacefaring race. Not within the next 100 years, perhaps even 1,000 years. But again, these are timescales that I can't even fathom in my small existence. We're talking about a galaxy that's billions of years old. We're talking about missions that could conceivably take hundreds of years to get to a nearest group of stars. So I think we need to start changing the way we think. And science fiction helps with the warp drive and all that. It kind of pushes in directions that we probably wouldn't understand. But in realistic terms, at least 100 years before that even becomes a possibility.
Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel here. And maybe you still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see what you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.
I wasn't talking too quick, was I?
No, that's good.